the silver medalist. Breaking news coming in right now. PV Sindhu bags the silver at the Rio Games. Carolina Marin, in the end, was too much for the rank 10 player in the world. Sindhu did her best, clawed her way back in most games. What a great champion, both Marin and PV Sindhu. She's done her best. It's glory for Spain. Glory also for India. Not as much though, but PV Sindhu doing her best. Let's go across to Shumon Ray at India Gate. Shumon, silver for India it is. Suman Ray, if you can hear me, you're live on air. Silver for India.
Hello, check.
I don't think we have Suman Ray right now. We'll get you his reaction in just a bit here. Novi, great play by Sindhu. She did her best. Ultimately, Marin, world number one, proving her medal.
No, I mean, you kept saying world number one against world number 10. It didn't seem like
it. It doesn't seem like that.
World number 10, Sindhu's going to go up in the rankings. Yeah, yeah. And, you know, definitely she stretched Carolina Marin in every way, physically, mentally. She's matched her stroke for stroke. Carolina Marin had that little bit extra, you know, in her repertoire of strokes. And also, we are talking, it's going to do good for, you know, in Europe, normally the badminton countries are Denmark and England to a certain extent, sometimes Russia,
Sweden
slightly. But now, I think it's going to be a sort of, you know, something like Spain winning Euro 2008 and, you know, suddenly Spanish football dominated. Carolina Marin, world champion, Olympic champion, you don't get better than that. And yeah, it's wonderful to see everybody even applauding her, because I think she played very cleverly at the end.
Yes.
Realizing she had an ankle problem, she tried to she finished the strokes off early and played to Sindhu's weaknesses, the cross-court drop shots and those shots dropping at Sindhu's feet.
I think we have Suman Ray live now from India Gate. Suman, it's a silver ultimately, but it did seem like two world champions were playing. The rankings didn't matter.
Yeah. और मात्र 21 साल की हैं पीवी सिंधु पहली बार ओलंपिक खेल से आई हैं ये है वो फाइनल
वी डोंट हैव डू वी हैव सुमन और नॉट
जहां पे कैरोलिना मरीन ने
All right, I believe Shumon is caught in the middle of a mob frenzy here, and we'll try and give him some time. In the meantime, Sunil, what a performance, both by Marin and by Sindhu.
Absolutely. When you look at them head to head, they were absolutely brilliant. This, according to me, is the best final in the history of Olympics in any gender.
Absolutely.
And it was only those few shots here and there that actually made the difference.
Absolutely. Sajid?
Amazing match. Hats off to both of them. You know, it's a bit unfortunate that we had to end up on the losing side, but kudos to them. What a great match.
Absolutely.
I think the quality of the match, both players pushed each other right up to the cliff. It's a bit unfortunate Sindhu had to lose. But then
somebody had to lose.
Yeah, absolutely.
Somebody had to lose. Of course, we saw the entire match together, and not at one moment did I feel that Sindhu was either outclassed or out of the game. She matched Carolina Marin stroke for stroke, smashing them.
Absolutely. It was a back-to-back. It was like a match-up to the equals.
If I can ask my video journalist to just show what kind of disappointment are there. Disappointed. How do you feel? Sindhu first match बहुत अच्छा जीता, बहुत अच्छा comeback किया. बाद में वो कर नहीं पाए, कहीं lost नजर आए, अपने form में नहीं नजर आए. या Carolina Marin was too good for her. बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छी निकली. क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
Number one के आगे compete कर रही बहुत बड़ी बात है. She did very fantastic job.
Carolina Marin कुछ ज़्यादा ही बेहतर निकली आज.
बेहतर ही निकले. हम लोगों ने एक्सेप्ट ज्यादा किया, लेकिन उसने जितना किया वो हिंदुस्तान के लिए बहुत ज्यादा ठीक है किया.
तो वो हौसला आपने क्या देखा कि कैरोलिना मैरिन थोड़ा ज्यादा अच्छी थी या सिंधु कर नहीं पाए, प्रेशर में आ गए या कुछ ज्यादा ही अनफोर्स्ड एरर भी कर रहे थे? कहीं ना कहीं देखा जाए तो मैरिन का जो गेम था वही खेल रही थी, वो पॉइंट्स भी वही दे रही थी, तो सिंधु की पॉइंट्स भी कैरोलिना मैरिन ही दे रही थी. तो कुछ स्मैशेस के अलावा देखा जाए तो आपको क्या कैसा असेसमेंट लगा?
थोड़ा सा तो प्रेशर था कि अभी तक सेकेंड जो सिल्वर पहले आ ही चुका था इसके बाद, लेकिन गोल्ड के लिए खेल रही थी क्योंकि अभी तक गोल्ड इंडिया में आया नहीं है. तो थोड़ा मैं डिसअपॉइंटेड हो या खुश हो कि सिल्वर मिल गया?
खुश है, सिल्वर मिला तो खुश है. ऐसा डिसअपॉइंटेड नहीं है, गोल्ड नहीं मिला तो.
पहला सेट जीतने के बाद आपको नहीं लगा कि ये गोल्ड मिल सकता था? वी केम सो क्लोज.
अनलकी डे फॉर सिंधु.
Okay, we came so close to gold medal, yet we just missed it.
It's okay. India पहली बार सिल्वर जीता है यार बैडमिंटन में पहली वुमेन जो सिल्वर जीती है बहुत है बहुत
हैप्पी पीपल आर यू हैप्पी वेल the scene over here is that they are disappointed, but more than disappointed, they know they must be following the game very closely. That's why they are saying they are very proud and happy that India has managed to win a silver medal and a historic silver medal at the Olympics.
Stay with us, Shimon. We have our, let's go across to our studio guests at this point in time. We have Saji Chakko, of course, co-editor of the Sunday Guardian. Saji, Sindhu remains a winner for India. She has bagged the medal, the first Indian shuttler to make it to the Olympic finals there.
Absolutely, Rashida. Win or loss, she's there. She's a champion.
PV Sindhu ki mehnat aur unka confidence dekhne ko milta tha. Unhone bahut se point cover kiye aur main samajhta hoon ki ek time par teesre set mein wo 10-10 par bhi aa gayi thi. पर जो मारिन है वो नंबर वन की खिलाड़ी है और सिंधु की रैंकिंग वो नहीं थी पर सिंधु ने जिस तरीके से उसका मुकाबला किया है मैं समझता हूं आज सिंधु नंबर दो की रैंकिंग पर आ गई है हमारे लिए बड़ी गर्व की बात है कि एक जगह साक्षी मलिक जीतती हैं दूसरी तरफ पीवी सिंधु सिल्वर मेडल जीतती है
पहले सेट में जीत के बाद आपको लगा था कि
हाँ मुझे तो पूरा लगा था कि वो दूसरा सेट भी जीत लेंगी कम से कम इस मैच को वो पूरा जीत लेंगी और पहले सेट के अंदर भी वो काफी पीछे थी पर जिस तरह से उन्होंने कवर अप किया तो वो कभी भी फाइट को छोड़ती नहीं है ये उनका कॉन्फिडेंस बोलता है
दूसरे सेट में भले ही बहुत
हाँ दूसरे सेट में मुझे नहीं लगा कि वो क्यों थोड़ा सा पीछे ज्यादा हो गई पर तीसरे सेट में उन्होंने पूरा मुकाबला किया है ऐसा मैं समझता हूँ
दो महिलाओं ने कान से एक रजत जीत लिया आपको आगे किस तरीके से दिख रहा है
ये शुरुआत है अभी हमारे रेसलिंग के अंदर जो पहलवान हैं उनसे भी हमको उम्मीद है और मैं समझता हूँ जैसा प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी कहते हैं कि हार और जीत खेल के अंदर होती है
We will be listening in to Vijay Goyal, the sports minister, reacting. Of course, it is a glorious moment for India. Take it away. Take a bow. PV Sindhu, you've done your nation proud tonight. You've won a silver medal. You've set history and you've inspired a million right across the nation to pick up a racket and join the academies and get cracking to build a generation of Olympic winners. Mohammed Kaif joins us on the broadcast. Michael Ferreira is still with us. Mohammed Kaif, good evening. What kind of message does this send, Mohammed Kaif, to the young ladies, young girls of India?
Even my four-year son was glued to TV and he was watching and supporting Sindhu and he was saying India, India. So that's what she has done to the whole nation. So it doesn't have to be cricket all the time. It can be badminton and it has to be badminton now because what Sindhu has achieved and the way she played, she fought and fought and fought and the aggression she has shown in this whole tournament, outstanding. You know,
something
salute
has changed.
To her.
Something has changed. You're right. And I appreciate you for saying it doesn't have to be cricket all the time. You know Novi Kapadia, we were all really glued to our screens. I mean, Athar has been doing commentary like you today, and it was epic. Something has changed, perhaps tonight. And you know, when we look back 10 years from now, something has changed tonight, Novi Kapadia.
Well, I've been through this much longer than everybody here. I still will, you know, in the Commonwealth Games at 2010, no greater personality like Sebastian Coe when the Indian women's team won the 400 to 400 meters, yeah. Cheered by a crowd of 70,000-80,000, said this is the moment for Asian athletics. It fell flat after that. So let's give it more time. If you do a show like this 1 month later, then I hope.
It's been non-stop coverage. Go ahead.
Yeah.
83 minutes of sheer brilliance and it combined.
It was it 83 minutes? It went really
well. Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, hang on. The parents are speaking. Let's listen in. Let's listen in to the mother of PV Sindhu, Ms. Vijaya. Listen in.
Thank you for giving us all the support, especially the press, the coverage, everything. And thanks to all the staff, especially the coach Gopi, the opposing staff, for giving us a silver medal to our country. Thank you. has won the first game. But you know, the second game, I know Marin is not an easy player. The way she has moved on the court today was excellent. This is what Sindhu has to learn, how to shout, scream against the opponent to...
I think we just lost that feed there. That was the Pulela Gopichand Academy in Hyderabad, where you can say hundreds, if not thousands of people had gathered. 500 people have signed up today, Michael Ferrara, to join this academy. 500 young kids have joined today this academy. How much of the precedent have we set tonight when we were waiting for that flag to rise over Rio tonight? How much of this is actually a game changer?
It's terrific. I mean, you've got to... the history of our sport shows that you've got to have a person who stands out, and that person's performances generate a whole new legion of players. It's happened in my sport, it's happened in tennis, it's happened in badminton, and obviously it's happened in sports like cricket. One outstanding person and the whole nation follows.
And here we have it. We've been good. So I mean, the badminton has probably never seen coverage like it has over the past few days. Let's open up our calling lines. Let's get the people of India involved in this conversation right across the length and breadth of this subcontinent. Let us cheer with respect for what this girl has shown with grit and determination. Shaji Chako, it was grit and determination. It was a never say die attitude. Right till the end.
Absolutely, you know, pluck, determination, call it. You have to give it to Sindhu. You know, it's unfortunate that in a final there will be winner and a loser. For me, both were the winners and losers. Fantastic performance. I think this is going to usher in a revolution in Indian badminton. More and more people are going to take to badminton.
Fingers crossed, Saji. Sarda Ugra joined us. Sarda Ugra, you know, Novi Kapadia says we've seen euphoria like this before. But do you feel the pulse of something different tonight, Sarda Ugra?
Athar, just I would like to answer the question before being interrupted after three sentences, like poor Mr. Ferreira has been and Saji has been. So please do bear
with me. You got the time, ma'am. Go ahead.
I agree with what Novi is saying. Because he is speaking about athletics, which is where it's happened. A revolution has already taken place in badminton over the last couple of years, and therefore we have seen, you know, we've got players in the top 20 amongst the men and amongst the women, which we've never had. In comparison, tennis looks a poor distant relative, like a country cousin of the way badminton is. And this, what Sindhu is able to do today and what Saina did 4 years ago, is just going to sort of create and kind of build this domino effect and keep building it. And, so the revolution in badminton certainly has taken place. A very interesting thing to realize, and I hope I'm not saying this and thereby, you know, bringing about doom, is that we don't know who the officials in badminton are anymore. We have no idea who's president of the Badminton Association. They are not part of the story,
okay.
Their scandals and their problems that they have. You don't read about it, you read about the players. You read about Sindhu, you read about Kidambi Srikanth, you read about Saina, you read about the next generation, Sikki Reddy, girls like that coming through, girls and boys coming through, Guru Sai Dutt, and that's the more important thing. And I hope I don't mean to offend people in Badminton Association, but I think that's a great job, you know, because your players are your story, your players are your stars. And Sindhu has now put herself up on a pedestal that everyone will want to match. They'll say, you know, hell, she can get to the final, I can get there and I can win gold. And that is what has happened in badminton.
Okay, just hang on, ma'am, hang on, ma'am. You're speaking of the federation, the federation chief is speaking out. Let's quickly listen in, then I want to invite a badminton player, Supriya Devgan, who's on the broadcast with me. Let's listen into that sound.
World champion ke khilaaf, world number one, Carolina ke khilaaf, itna achha performance dena, aur ek well fought game tha ye, aur jis tarah se unki performance hai, मैं समझता हूं कि सिंधु का खेल किसी मामले में कैरोलिना से कम नहीं था. कैरोलिना थोड़ी एक्सपीरियंस पे ज्यादा है, लेकिन ये अपने आप में एक बहुत बड़े गौरव की बात है. मैं इसका 125 करोड़ लोगों के लिए गर्व की बात है कि हमारी सिंधु सिल्वर मेडल जीत के आई हैं, न केवल बैडमिंटन में बल्कि इंडियन हिस्ट्री में, ओलंपिक्स हिस्ट्री में वो पहली महिला एथलीट हैं किसी भी गेम में चाहे हो जो सिल्वर मेडल लेके आई है. और इससे निश्चित रूप से देश के जो अन्य खिलाड़ी हैं, बच्चे हैं हमारे जो अपना कैरियर बनाना चाहते हैं स्पोर्ट्स में, उनको निश्चित रूप से इससे बहुत लाभ मिलेगा, प्रेरणा मिलेगी. और मुझे उम्मीद है कि सिंधु तो बहुत अच्छा करेंगी आने वाले एशियन गेम्स में, कॉमनवेल्थ में गेम्स में, और 2020 के ओलंपिक की बात भी मैं कहता हूं. उसके अलावा हमें और भी बहुत सारी सिंधु मिलेंगी और भी बहुत सारे श्रीकांत मिलेंगे. और इसीलिए आज हम लोग ने बैडमिंटन एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडिया ने सिंधु के को सम्मान देने के लिए 50 लाख रुपए का पुरस्कार घोषित किया है सिंधु के लिए और उनके कोच गोपीचंद के लिए 10 लाख रुपए का पुरस्कार घोषणा की है और 10 लाख रुपए श्रीकांत जो कि बहुत अच्छा खेले क्वार्टर फाइनल में उनके लिए भी घोषणा की गई है। साथ ही 15 लाख रुपए जो अन्य सपोर्ट स्टाफ है जो कोचेज है या अन्य जो फिजियोथेरेपिस्ट है उन लोगों को कभी कुछ नहीं मिलता है लेकिन उनको भी 15 लाख
Congratulatory messages for PV Sindhu, even though she's gotten a silver, which is one less than the gold, that doesn't make her any less of a champion. She's made India proud at Rio, the best performance by an Indian athlete till now. Remember, there are a couple of bouts of wrestling to go. We are hopeful that they will get us a medal, but PV Sindhu, what a beautiful performance right now. Joining us right now, Sharda Ugra, senior sports commentator and writer. Also with us, Supriya Devgan, former badminton player. And Mohammed Kaif, former Indian cricketer, also joining us on the panel. First, Sharda, to you. You're joining us on the broadcast right now. My neck is a little strained because I've been jumping up and down on the broadcast. What a match PV Sindhu played today. She played right out of her skin. Even though she didn't win in the end, I think there are no losers tonight. And there's a one winner. The winner is badminton and Indian badminton more so. Can Sharda Ugra hear me? I don't think she can hear me right now. We'll try and connect with her. Supriya Devgan, you saw the match, I'm presuming. Thank you for joining us, first of all. PV Sindhu, what a performance. What a champion in the making.
Thank you. Absolute champion in the making. I think she's made India very, very, very proud. She's played a fantastic tournament. This tournament, we've seen a Sindhu that we've never seen before. What aggression, what court coverage, what mental stability, absolutely fantastic performance, which kept getting better match after match. We were hoping to see the same aggression today. Somehow she started really, really slow. Also, Carolina was playing a very flat and fast-paced game, and Sindhu was not being able to get the length, which is the strength of her game somehow. But however, she's done the country proud and she's played a fantastic, fantastic match today.
Absolutely. As we speak right now, she is getting her medal. She's showing her silver medal to the entire world and the Indian contingent at Rio at that badminton court. Finally, a smile from PV Sindhu. She's been focused so hard in the last couple of days. I think this is the first time I'm seeing her smile and she deserves it, doesn't it, Novi?
Yes, she fully deserves it. She's won our hearts by an absolutely brilliant display. And as Sharda was talking earlier before you joined us, that, you know, hopefully does spark off a type of revolution. Lots of more people joining badminton. I believe more people have signed for Gopichand's badminton. Absolutely. And credit also to the federation, again, which Sharda talked about, that, you know, the federation has kept in the background and let the players do it. And as I said, if we can widen the base, with Sindhu's victory, as Michael Ferreira has been saying, you know, when you get champions, you trigger off something.
Absolutely.
And hopefully more badminton academies, good coaches, and more young women and men playing.
Saji.
Yeah, I think I'll take off from where Novi said. I think this will be a world of good for Indian badminton. Indian badminton has been really resurgent. Gopichand is the one person who is responsible for that. And I hope Sindhu's success, I mean, a silver, I will still call it a success, nevertheless, she's lost the final, but usher in more and more youngsters to the game, and broaden the base. India is such a populous country. Yep. And there's so much talented people, so many talented
badminton
youngsters.
Badminton is played in almost in every home.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, That's the point.
I think we can be the badminton powerhouse in the next 10 years. Sharda Ugra, I hope you can hear me right now. I'm going to venture into a couple of unfortunate puns, but I cannot resist since I've just spoken to you. First, right now, there was a couple of, there was a twist in the game, mostly Marin's ankle, but India left feeling the pain now. But we are not at all disappointed. We are very proud of PV Sindhu. She is truly a champion.
She put up an outstanding performance today. She's had an excellent Olympic tournament. She played with aggression, she played with confidence. She was against a player who just happened to be better than she was on the day. A player who's left-handed, so that makes that kind of throws you off your game a little bit because she's coming at different angles. And a very polished and a very accomplished player. Absolutely. And Sindhu was up against her, and we before the match started, our first instinct was Sindhu's been a bit of a giant slayer, so maybe she'll be able to do it this time. But she did, literally, she took her game right to the very end, as far as she could. She stretched it as long as and as wide as she could, and she had outstanding performances all on her way to the final. It wasn't an easy ride at all. It was just a performance that was as worthy of whatever medal she was given.
As we speak, Sharda, right now, the level
of badminton that an Indian girl can play today.
As we speak, Sharda, right now, the podium, the photographs are being taken. Carolina Marin, the Spanish champion, in tears as the Spanish national anthem plays at Rio. PV Sindhu right by her side, and the Japanese player who Sindhu beat in the semis also there. The podium finishes right now. All players kissing their medals, and PV Sindhu cracks a smile. What an amazing and scintillating display of badminton we've seen tonight. And all three players on the podium right now. PV Sindhu, of course, leading the Indian charge at the Rio Olympics. At least we got a podium finish right after Sakshi Malik. And it's a one better silver it is than Mohammed Kaif. And Michael Ferreira also with us. Mohammed Kaif, what a brilliant performance by PV Sindhu. She just missed the gold by a whisker, but she played like a true champion. And when she returns, she will return to a hero's welcome.
Say the way she played the previous matches, she shown the aggression, she was moving very fast across the court. But this match today, it was a big game for her, and against world number one Marin, she looked like a very mature player, very fast, and being a lefty, like Sharda said correctly, the angle played a major role for her. And I would say a bit of nerve playing a major final for the first time. But like you said, she has won million hearts. We are proud of her, and all the best. Family must be very proud, whole nation, myself, my family, we all watched the game. So, yes, proud moment.
Absolutely, and celebrations are already happening across the country. In the middle of your screens right now, the tricolor waving high. There are celebrations for the silver medal that PV Sindhu has just won for the country, and these are various locations across the country with banners and flags and firecrackers celebrating the greatness of one champion in the making right now. She got us the silver medal at Rio. It's our best performance at these Olympic Games, and PV Sindhu has written herself into the history books today. PV Sindhu, just 23 years old, award of Pulela Gopichand, former champion, and what a journey it has been, Sunil, Yash, Kalra. For PV Sindhu, what a journey.
Absolutely. It's nothing short of historic moment in the history of Indian sports. What was the difference? The only thing that differentiated between a gold and a silver was Sindhu won most of the rallies.
Yes.
If you see the long rally, she was really up onto it. However, the Spanish girl rushed on to her, and she took away the quick points. And
absolutely,
I think that was the difference. And you can't be in a big match, you can't be trailing forever. You can't do the catch-up game in the third set.
And imagine, let's also take a look at the future. Michael Ferreira, it's going to do PV Sindhu's confidence a world of good today. She played the world number one, didn't play like the world number 10 player. It looked like their one and two were playing. And she has a tournament coming up in 15 to 20 days. Imagine the confidence she goes into that tournament with. I mean, that is irreplaceable. That cannot be discounted.
Absolutely. I want to say something, that while we are thankful to her and grateful for the high that she's given us, you have to concede that Carolina Marin played a fantastic game.
Absolutely.
She played
no
a very, very crafty game, and she pulled out every trick in the book, from time wasting to querying the umpire, to changing the shuttle, to drinking, to break up rhythm. It was a virtuoso performance, not necessarily connected with the game itself.
No, absolutely. And it's also reflective, isn't it, Sharda Ugra? It's also reflective of how much respect Marin gave PV Sindhu, because she tried everything, every trick in the book, and only then could she manage. She lost the first game and then had to crawl her way back into the second and third. She did lead those two games, but it took everything that Marin had really at her disposal to beat the 23-year-old Indian.
I I think what would have been on the back of Marin's mind, Mr. Ferreira, being a competitor himself, has recognized it immediately, is the fact that if Sindhu started collecting a whole lot of points together, she tended to get on a roll, get far more aggressive, attack a lot more, smash a lot more, and then literally run over, which is what happened in the first game, run over whatever that she was offered by Carolina Marin. And I think that's where Carolina Marin said, all right, when Sindhu kind of came back into the third game, came close to her, around 10 points and so on, and that's when she sort of slowed it down, and she had a problem with her ankle, and she was talking to the judge, and literally it's like she kind of took the energy, or she took that whole momentum away from what Sindhu was doing. And then she was able to get the game back played at the pace that she wanted the game to be played in. So again, like a very crafty player, she is world number one, she's European champion, she's world champion, and she beat Saina Nehwal in the 2015 World Championship final. So, a great competitor, a great badminton player, along with Saina, one of the players who literally broke the Chinese stranglehold on badminton, say for about the last 5 years or so. It's been her, and it's been the player from Thailand and Saina Nehwal who have sort of broken the Chinese stranglehold over the sport.
And that's no mean achievement in itself, really. The silver is the icing on the cake, and when she does return, I believe Prime Minister Modi has also congratulated PV Sindhu and has said that her achievement is historic. She can prepare for a boisterous welcome when she does come back. We have a caller from Chennai. Preet, go ahead.
Hi, good evening. This is Preetha Maria from Chennai.
Okay, Preetham, go ahead.
My congratulations to PV Sindhu, her proud parent and her coach Gopi. And I wish her all the best. She has done a marvelous performance today, which we are all Indians are proud of. And I think she is going to inspire millions of young girls in times to come.
Absolutely.
My only request to the nation, Prime Minister, bureaucracy, keep your fingers and heads away from sports. Let it be done by the professionals, by the coaches who know the game. Kind request to bureaucrats, politicians, stay away from sports. Keep your fingers away from sports.
All right. Thank you, Preetham, for joining us. And we will take a short break right now. I think Pulela Gopichand is a case in point. When you let the experts handle it, this is what comes out. PV Sindhu. Olympic silver medalist, making India proud. Short break. PV Sindhu, the Hyderabad girl, the 23-year-old, played like a champion today and got India its first silver medal at the Rio Olympics. It's the best performance by an Indian athlete in these Rio Games, and both our medals have come from girls who fought long and hard to make India proud and prove their mettle at the international stage. Let's also go across now to my colleague in Rio. Manish Awasthi joins us live from Rio de Janeiro. Manish, what a game did PV Sindhu play today. She played out of her skin in the end, got the silver medal, but in the process won a billion hearts.
Yeah, you're right. A tall and lanky girl from Hyderabad did try her best till the last set, wherein it could be a deciding set, when she ranked second in the world and in this tournament. But I can say that she tried her best. First set was the exciting set, wherein she did her best. And second set, Marilini took over Carolini, and she outbeat Sindhu. So third set was, she still tried till the last, but unfortunately she could not make it for gold. But yes, it's a tall height for the India as well, who was a medal hungry, and she could find a spot in the silver medal category for the nation. So it's a great moment, it's a pride moment, and we all are proud here that she could get us a silver medal for the country, for the game, and she has written many pages in the history of becoming the first badminton, a first shuttler to be there in the finals, to get the medal, and so on. So history will be repeated or not is a big question, but yes, we can say that we can look up to the Tokyo Olympics, wherein she will be prepared, she will be preparing herself to perform to the best and get a gold medal next time. So there's always next time. It's an opportunity to start again with intelligently. We should look up with that optimism.
Absolutely. And also the tournaments in the middle that she will be playing, World Championships, the All England and what have you. PV Sindhu is going to be a threat in all those tournaments, and we are going to be watching each and every game now. I think the way Saina Nehwal is the badminton poster girl, Novi. I think PV Sindhu has now gotten up to that level with this performance right now. Before I come back to you on that, I think we'll just play for a quick few minutes here. The medal ceremony about to be, in fact, yes, that those are shots coming in. We can't play those live shots, remember, because of copyright issues. But yes, yeah, I think we can now. We are playing those. This is a repeat telecast there. That's PV Sindhu getting a silver medal and cracking that smile that we talked about, really. Haven't seen her smile too often, but now that she has won the silver medal, PV Sindhu can afford to smile, and smile she did. This happened just a few moments ago. She's showing her silverware, if I could call it that, to the entire world. Proud parents back in Hyderabad. Proud coach Pulila Gopisan right there beside her. A podium finish for India, a better one than Sakshi Malik. She won the bronze in the 58 kg category in wrestling. PV Sindhu in the men's females badminton final narrowly lost to the world number one, Carolina Marin. But what a performance it was, and it has catapulted, I believe, PV Sindhu into the league of great players to come in the next 5 years or so. Before I go back to Manish Awasthi and Supriya Devgan, Novi Kapadia, what Saina Nehwal was for badminton, we now have two people in the same category. That can only mean good news for badminton.
That's a plus point, but I hope we are also all realizing that, you know, I call this, you know, when we saw this medal giving ceremony, no Chinese girl, you know, Sydney, Athens, London. Beijing, London, there would only be Chinese girls on the podium. Is this the Abebe Bikila moment in the history of women's badminton, at least? Because, you know, when Bikila won in 1960 Rome Olympics, that's when Africa came into the upsurge in athletics. When Kip Keino outclassed Jim Ryan in the 1968 1500 meters, and after that, well, we did have a few Sepko and all coming, but then slowly the Africans took over. Is this going to be a change? You know, it's also Spain. I mean, you know, you're going to have a lot of European women also getting inspired by her win. But definitely for India, this could be a game-changing moment. And the fear of the Chinese has gone.
Absolutely. Supriya Devgan, now, would you say what this particular win and this fantastic performance, this great run in the Olympics by PV Sindhu is going to inspire more and more people, especially young girls, to take up badminton? Do you think this silver medal will do for India what Leander Paes's bronze in Atlanta did for tennis in India?
Absolutely, it will. I think this is the start of our golden girl with the silver medal today. She's won a million hearts. She's inspired millions of young hearts to join the sport, as you said. The Pulela Gopichand Academy today looked like a football ground with about 5,000 people watching this game on big screen. And as you correctly said, there have been almost 500 people wanting to join the movement. And I'm very, very closely associated with Gopi, and I will do my best that I can in making him accessible, like we say, making excellence accessible and helping grow the sport in the country now.
If you were to point out, Supriya, one particular aspect of Sindhu's play today that she can perhaps improve upon, we all know she's slightly weak at the net. Anything else you want to point out today?
Well, as they say that the taller you are, the more difficult it becomes to take the net shots. I'm sure she's going to work on it. And on a lighter note, what I do know is Vishnu, who's Gopi Chand's son, has been doing his bit, giving a lot of net practice to Sindhu while she's been training hard on her road to the Olympics. The only thing I'd say is there has to be, I mean, we see a lot more aggression in her game as of this tournament. But I do know there was a moment when Gopi actually made Sindhu stand in the middle of a court and made all the players stop playing, saying, Sindhu, none of them will play till you don't actually scream. And she actually screamed so loud, and that was his way of bringing aggression into her game. So even today, as we saw, Carolina kept the pace very, very fast, kept the game, the shuttle very flat. And that's what was getting the better of Sindhu. So
all right.
Aggression is what I would think. Is
thank you, Supriya Devgan, for talking to us and pointing that out to us. And that also, in fact, is reflective, isn't it, of Pulela Gopichand's style and the ingenious ways, really, that he trains his horse. Michael Ferreira joins us back now, former world billiard champion. Before I come back to you, sir, let me just quickly go across to Manish Awasthi in Rio. Manish, how did the Indian contingent? I believe there were a lot of Indians with waving tricolours at the court today, cheering and egging PV Sindhu on. I'm sure they must be delighted by the performance, but there was enough support in the form of Indians visiting Rio for any player, especially PV Sindhu.
In fact, they came with a lot of hopes here with the kind of excitement that was built since the time that she has won silver medal. It was known to all. It was an assured medal that has come to the kitty of India. But when Sindhu could not make it to gold, they were a bit upset, but they are still happy that she could do it for India by getting a silver medal. So it was like they are not upset, but they wanted that she should get gold. It was an expectation and optimism, but not necessary that it should turn up all the time. The way you think, she performed her best. She tried to slam every set to Caroline Marini, but unfortunately, Caroline got the gold, and she has to rest with the silver. So it's not about that Indian fans are upset. They are really happy. They are in a mood wherein they would have cheered it more. They would have been more jubilant. But yes, of course, they are happy that India has got a silver, and that too, it's just sheer effort of PV Sindhu that India ranks in the silver category of the medal tally, and India couldn't find a spot in the medal tally in the silver lining.
Absolutely. It's actually a silver lining, really, if you look at the larger picture of sports and Olympic sport in India and the competitive levels that Indian athletes, of course, are right now. We're also being joined right now by Kishore Bhimani, senior sports commentator. Before I go back to Sharda and my other panelists, good evening to you, Kishore Bhimani. What a performance. What scintillating stroke play by PV Sindhu. Not enough to get a gold, but enough to win a billion hearts tonight.
I personally think that this was a great match of great strategy. Carolina Marin was absolutely determined not to allow Sindhu to get onto her feet, to get her aggressive game, get her matches going, dictate the game from the baseline. She just didn't allow it, and Marin was the point was the pressure built up by Sindhu, that Sindhu, when she's 1-6 down, she makes it 6-all. Yes. When she's 1-4 down, she makes it 4-all. And in the second set, I think that first set, to be 16-19 down, when all seemed lost, she made it 19-all, and with that magnificent right court placement, she won that. To me, that was a high point. It was the most fantastic game of competitive, aggressive badminton I've seen.
Absolutely, and we did discuss that while we were live there and commentating on it, and we noticed really how she made those long yawning gaps shorter by sheer grit and determination and dazzling stroke play. Before I go back to Sharda and Novi and other guests, I believe Rajavardhan Rathore, the INV minister, has reacted on PV Sindhu's silver medal. Let's take a look.
देखिए पूरे विश्व के अंदर जितने भी बैडमिंटन खिलाड़ी हैं आज की तारीख में उसमें नंबर दो स्थान पर आना एक बहुत बड़ी बात है और खास तौर पे 10वें स्थान पे थी उनकी वर्ल्ड रैंकिंग उसके बावजूद उन्होंने वर्ल्ड नंबर 2 को हराया और आज वर्ल्ड नंबर 1 जो अपना स्थान बरकरार करे हुए थे इस मुकाबले के अंदर यानी उनमें भी दम था उनके साथ जबरदस्त मुकाबला करा फाइनल में भारतवर्ष के लिए बहुत हर्ष की बात है और दो बेटियों ने हमें रास्ता दिखाया है ये भी एक देश के लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है हमें गौरवान्वित महसूस करना चाहिए और बिल्कुल गौरवान्वित हैं हम और मैं बधाई देना चाहूंगा पीवी सिंधु को उनके पूरे परिवार को पुलेला गोपीचंद को पूरी एकेडमी को कि उनके इस रजत पदक से कई और स्वर्ण पदक भारत की तरफ आए ऐसा उन्होंने जो इंस्पिरेशन दिया है उसके लिए मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहूंगा
क्या इस हार में भी हमारी जीत है
बेशक बिल्कुल ये एक पायदान होते हैं और आज जिस पायदान पे हमारी दो बेटियां पहुंची हैं उस पायदान से छलांग लगा कि ना जाने कितने युवा और आगे निकलेंगे बहुत बेहतरीन प्रदर्शन था वी आर एब्सोल्युटली प्राउड ऑफ देम
इस मेडल की अहमियत को शायद आपसे बेहतर कोई नहीं समझ सकता क्योंकि आप ही कभी इसके हिस्सा रहे हैं और आपने जीता है क्या लगता है कि किस तरह से उनका वेलकम किया जाना चाहिए और किस तरह से स्पोर्ट्समैनशिप को महिलाओं में इंडिया में इंक्रीज करने की जरूरत है
उनका वेलकम वैसे ही होना चाहिए जैसे किसी विजेता का हो
और एक तरह से वो जीत हासिल करके आई हैं, इतने सारों को वहां पर हरा कर आई हैं, भारत का झंडा लहराया है विश्व के परचम पर और विश्व स्टेज पर, तो बहुत ही हमारे लिए फख्र की बात है।
All right, that was Rajyavardhan Rathore congratulating PV Sindhu and her family, father and mother. Speaking of whom, they've also reacted right now. Let's take a look at Mr. Ramanna and P. Vijaya, the father and mother of PV Sindhu speaking out. Take a look.
We are very happy the performance which she has exhibited. And of course, Carolina has played an excellent game and she truly deserves the championship gold medal. However, we assure you that under the guidance of her coach, in the coming years, Sindhu will definitely perform well and keeps the hopes of all the Indians high.
She definitely won the hearts of all the Indians. She is the youngest women player to win silver medal. So we are happy, but we congratulate Marin. She played an extraordinary game today. So Sindhu, she played little dull. So.
All right, that was the mother and father of PV Sindhu congratulating their daughter, of course. And it's a big day for India, isn't it, Sunil Yashkalra? It's a big day because one of our youngsters went onto the world stage, competed, and won the silver medal. I believe Marin won. It wasn't as if PV Sindhu lost.
Absolutely. It changes the narrative of the entire situation. Yes. Who was she up against? High-ranked player? She was playing the best, perhaps the best badminton of her life. And you have to give it to Sindhu. This was her first Olympic big outing. Mm-hmm. So, obviously, she was up against all the odds. And despite that, she takes her into the third set and was like a close call. So, I think full marks to Sindhu, the way she's done it. And I think her parents have really put it into the right perspective, saying that the better player of the day actually won the gold medal.
Absolutely. As is true, Saji, of any sport, any game, any tournament, yes.
I think full marks to her parents. They acknowledged, sport is the winner. I think sport is the winner. Sindhu, she may have lost, but she's won a billion odds.
Yeah.
What a performance. She wore India's flag on her sleeve, literally, came out there, all guns blazing. Mm. And mind you, it's the first time Carolina Marin has been taken to a three game in the entire
Absolutely,
tournament.
Yes.
What further can we speak about
Absolutely.
Sindhu?
Absolutely. Who was the one to do it?
Yes.
PV Sindhu
yes.
did. Michael Ferreira, it's ultimately any game, any sport, you take any sort of game which involves physical activity. There has to be a winner, there has to be a loser. Whoever plays better on the day will win. Marin did play better today, but that does not take away from PV Sindhu and her journey and her achievement today.
Absolutely. I just wanted to point out, Novi mentioned about this being a game changer for the game of badminton. I believe it's going to be a game changer for Indian society as a whole. Parents will no longer insist, manic insistence on studies like they used to traditionally do. They can see that sport is a viable alternative. So putting that tremendous pressure on kids to be toppers will, I think, have to change. Also, the prejudice against girl children, which is so sad in our society, will slowly disappear. And I think that is where the game changer is all about. Indian society as a whole is poised to change.
Absolutely.
I hope it happens. We will see it happen.
Absolutely. And there are enough female athletes that can be icons, really. We started with Sania Mirza. Saina Nehwal came into the picture. Mary Combe. Now Sakshi Malik. The other wrestlers. The Pogats. And now we have PV Sindhu, Novi Kapadia. It couldn't get better.
Yes, it couldn't get better. And I mean, they've all, I mean, starting from PT Usha and Karna Maleswari was with us earlier. They triggered off revolutions in their own sport. Well, badminton, as Sharda, who was with us earlier, said, is already well established, but we have now to expand the base. I agree with what Michael Ferreira is saying. Let there be more competition. you know, Saina Nehwal and PV Sindhu are a cut above everybody else. Mm. Let there be more girls challenging them, and then everybody will get better. And also, can there be a thinking, you know, a social type of revolution that, you know, sports is an outlet, but you need facilities and infrastructure absolutely. Also for that, not just for the Olympic level athletes.
And also the mindset, I think the parents' mindset perhaps will change. That's the seed really which we need. Yeah.
You know, now I'm sure more and more parents will encourage their daughters to take to the game, because this has been a girls' Olympics. Unfortunately, I don't want to say it, I don't want to be saying this, but no Indian male winner. I think this speaks volumes for our daughters. They've done India proud.
Sehwag got it right when he said absolutely in his tweet there. Mohammed Kaif, I want to come to you for that. Viru got it right when he tweeted that jab bhi desh ki izzat ka sawal aata hai, to ladkiyan hi malik hain. She was of course referring to Sakshi Malik, and he's been proved right again by PV Sindhu.
Not to forget Deepak.
See, bilkul,
Deepak
ji,
I come from a Muslim background. I know my niece, you know, being a girl child, they also want to play the sport, and the parents have started doing it. I mean, we still have got a long way to go where parents come up and say that to their children, go out there and achieve your dream, especially the girl child. But what Sindhu has set the example for us, and I'm sure in the future you will see lots of girl child coming out there and achieve their dreams. And I want to wish them all the best, you know. Salute to all the parents, you know. Already started happening. It's not that we are lacking behind, holding our child not to go out there and take up the sport. But after tonight, after this day, I'm sure parents must be way more open for the girl child to go out there and play and heart out and do the nation proud.
And I think Kef is right. It's already started happening, hasn't it, Sunil? It's already in the process. The transition is visible. We can see by how many people turned up, really, at the Purila Gopichand Academy, and how many people have signed up, really, even before Sindhu won the silver.
In fact, if you look at the India Gate, the atmosphere was electric, as our colleague pointed out from there. What it will do to Indian sport, and especially badminton and wrestling, government will be forced to infuse more funds to it. It'll allocate more international training. Mm. Currently, we have the top scheme, and here they give 250 days of camp/ international tour exposure. They get to choose their own coaches. They get to get their mental trainers along with them, and I think they're helping it to expand not only at the base of the pyramid but also at the middle, which Novi pointed out, right? No,
absolutely, yes. Novi.
Yes, certainly you have to get the base of the pyramid expanded, because we generally, the whole tradition in Indian sports, you have one or two people coming up.
Correct.
So, you know, that has to change. Mm. And to give the government of India credit also, they have invested money in sports now. In fact, basic infrastructure really only the government of India does. The management has to get better.
Absolutely.
Social thinking has to get better. We have to start thinking of a, you know, sports revolution.
And
think also that gradually, you know, don't be in a hurry.
Yes.
It's not a T20 match.
It's not going to happen overnight. Champions take time to make, prepare, and their skills to be honed. I also want to go back to another champion. Baichung Bhutia is back with us. He is a former football captain for the country. Baichung, two medals till now in the Rio Olympics, both by young athletes, both are girls. Will women power be redefined now in making India a sporting superpower?
I hope it does, because you know, this Olympics has been the biggest example of it, and we obviously in India don't get to see a lot of women in making it big in sports, and so I hope a lot of girls, a lot of you know, parents does support their girl child or, you know, a girl to take up sports. And I think there have been Sindhu, Sania, Saina have been the biggest example. Marie Com have been the biggest example for successful women sports person in India. And I hope they will set the trend and everyone else to follow.
And we all know what to expect next, don't we, Saji? There will be awards for Sindhu, there will be cash prizes, but is that really enough? Is that what they need, really? I'm sure they need it, of course, and they should be given it. But that's not where the line should end, really, doesn't it, Saji?
Athar, you know, she'll be poured by accolades, by incentives, land, you name it, cash. But please, let's broad base, the facilities for our sportsmen, as Novi and Sunil rightly said. This is the right time to have more and more people take more and more girls to sports. Mm. And how do you do it? By investing in infrastructure, by broad-basing your base. And I think Sindhu's fantastic effort should be a perfect catalyst for everyone to take to sports, especially the parents. They are the doubting Thomases who think, look, maybe...
I think the government as well as sporting bodies, we invest enough in sports, but do we invest enough in sports persons?
That's the question. Thing.
Yeah, Sunil first and then Novi.
In fact, in the last 2 years, Government of India, according to the top scheme, has invested 350 crores. Now, by any stretch of imagination, that's not a meager amount. Mm. That's quite substantial. Also, they've increased the foreign coaches to around 40. Yeah. They pay them handsome salary. Roland Altman's gets around more than a corporate honcho would, So, I think the mindset is changing. The change would take time. And it's, as you said, it's not like a T20 that you start expecting results from the next month,
Absolutely. I think Michael Ferreira wants to come in on this point here. Michael, do we invest enough in our sports persons, not just the sport?
There's something I'd like to put out to the viewers. I don't think any single event has united the whole of India like this particular match. I think it's been a tremendous force for good. And I think this is where the corporate sector has to sit up and take notice. And I think the CSR must kick in big time. Let them invest more in sport, in sporting infrastructure, and not merely looking at the bottom line. It is time for the corporate sector to take the principle of CSR much more seriously.
Absolutely. Novi?
Yeah, very good point. Because my sort of large association with Indian sport is that the corporate sector in India is very impatient. They want results immediately. You have got some results in cricket, so then the tendency is to, make a mad rush towards just one sport. Mm. You have to realize Olympic sports, the competition level is much more intense. And they should, as Michael says, the CSR should be much more serious. And hopefully, I agree with Michael that very rarely in a non-cricket sport has the whole country been so united.
Absolutely.
So hopefully there can be a shift in the focus in the media also.
Sure.
Because yes, during the Olympics, Asian Games, Commonwealth Games now, there's a lot of media exposure. But it must continue for the whole year. There should be a balanced coverage.
It should not be just for the duration of
the Olympics. Duration of these big events. If there's a balanced coverage, it'll inspire more people.
I'm completely out of time right now, but I do want to say one last thing before I end the show. I thank my guests. Since you spoke and Michael spoke about how this particular match and this particular individual has united the country in more ways than one, I spoke to the father and mother early in the morning. They started their prayers, their day with prayers at the temple they like to go to. In the afternoon, I spoke to Raza Murad, the actor, and he said in his community, it's Friday today, and there were special prayers held for Juma, for PV Sindhu to win a medal. I think PV Sindhu and her biggest achievement is that she's brought the country together for one purpose and one purpose only. And that's what we saw today across the country. I think that's our biggest achievement today.
Absolutely.
We will end the show right now. Thank you, Manish Awasthi, for joining us from Rio. For Sunil Yashkalra, Saji Chakho, Michael Ferreira, Novi Kapadia, Sharda Ugra, Baichung Bhutia, Mohammed Kaif, and all the others who joined us. Congratulations to PV Sindhu, her family, and to the entire country for the silver medal. I'm Athar Khan. Good night.